This is an EZ64 review of Animal Crossing New Horizons. Gradually innovating over four main series entries before New Horizons, does the Animal Crossing series provide its best overall experience in this 2020 title, or is this pandemic-friendly life sim better left behind with COVID-19? The answer is surprisingly complicated. Playing a game like this for approximately 200 hours gives a player a different perspective, and many different types of people play Animal Crossing for many different reasons. As such, I'll be focusing on the first week or two of New Horizons first. Moments found in the initial campaign of New Horizons are some of the best in the series. I use the word campaign loosely, but there truly is one like no other in the series, and I think it's important it gets attention even months after release. When my partner Colton and I started our island life on a rock in the ocean we dubbed True North, we were ecstatic to return to the Animal Crossing series. For fans, New Horizons immediately presented familiar elements in a brand new way. Whether it was beloved characters like Tom Nook or KK Slider being shown off in an exciting fresh light, or gameplay features that were streamlined into the Nook Phone, a device that is effectively a much better user interface than anything the series has had before, New Horizons proudly stated that this was a game that was a bigger step up from New Leaf than any previous sequel had been from its predecessor. The first week or two on True North for us were invigorating. And that likely amounted to at least 40 hours of gameplay alone. We were constantly discovering new creatures to curate for blathers, new things to buy, and special guests like Flick, CJ, and Daisy May to meet. The sense of ownership this time around was absolutely my favorite addition. Instead of moving somewhere that already featured a Nook's Cranny or an Able Sisters, the player or players have to build these familiar amenities. That consists of gathering the appropriate materials for building these stores, choosing a location on your island for them to be built, and participating in a ceremony that lets you keep your memory of accomplishment forever. This sense of customization extends fully into the game's identity, which goes its deepest when the Island Designer app is unlocked at the end of the campaign. This feature allows the player to design custom pathways, edit waterways like rivers and ponds, and create and destroy cliffsides. Thousands of players around the world have used these features to create stunning islands that New Leaf players would have never dreamed of, and it's a testament to waiting this long for a new installment in a franchise that, finally, Animal Crossing found the chance to at least partially reinvent itself. Returning elements returned for a reason. While simple, nothing quite beats the quiet relaxation of fishing or the pulse-pounding efforts to try to catch the fastest dragonfly. Home decoration has always been a favorite, and with New Horizons, there are many innovations largely inspired by spin-offs Happy Home Designer and Pocket Camp that make arranging furniture and wall hangings a cinch. While crafting tools can admittedly be a small annoyance, the outrage over it is even more overblown than breakable weapons in Breath of the Wild, crafting other items, from seasonal decorations like the Cherry Blossom furniture set to more natural furniture sets made of iron and wood, is all a joy. With do-it-yourself recipes aplenty, there's always something new to find even 200 hours into the game. It's a small part that plays into the overall philosophy of playing the game year-round. And like never before, the developers mean for players to enjoy the game at its own pace, and for several months ahead. Instead of being able to warp the system's clock and experience everything the game has to offer like an impatient kitsune, updates are being added to New Horizons year-round, and perhaps even beyond 2021, to introduce some familiar elements that are admittedly still missing. For instance, diving for ocean creatures, an exciting feature that was there from the start in Animal Crossing New Leaf, was just recently added into the game for the month of July. The same can be said for other trickling features over the past few months, including the art section of the museum, holidays like the dreaded Bunny Day, and other new and old events alike. There's a strong chance that future months can reintroduce us to lovable characters like Brewster, the coffee-prone pigeon, or Lottie, the cute otter from Happy Home Designer, but truly only time will tell. This design philosophy has gotten some flack from fans, but it's not inherently a bad idea either. It's more like a double-edged sword. Sure, some additional content may be in waiting for the right season, but it also works well in showing that Animal Crossing is an evergreen title that is meant to be enjoyed at a more relaxed pace than other games. It is a series about listening to the comical ramblings of one's animal villagers and spending hours deciding what wallpaper fits the living room after all. Once I stopped obsessing about paying off my final bank loan or getting all the fossils in the game, I started to thoroughly enjoy Animal Crossing New Horizons again, in part expressly due to its evergreen nature, like catching the July fish and bugs, or recruiting some of the memorable new villager additions, including Raymond the Cat and Audie the Wolf. It's worth noting that, despite some flaws in the online interface, New Horizons became the most social I've ever been with a Nintendo game. Perhaps in due part to the state of the world, I found myself reconnecting with over a dozen real-life friends who I had never imagined would play Animal Crossing to such an extent. There's a unique, charmful joy to visiting the islands of loved ones and new friends alike. Showing off True North on this very YouTube channel inspired me to showcase some of my friends' islands as well, and the social joys of Animal Crossing New Horizons have yet to wear thin. To me, New Horizons feels like an imperfect masterpiece. By far, it's my favorite entry in the series, and with future updates, it'll likely only become an even more well-rounded package. It's got its kinks and perhaps some obvious quality of life changes that could further streamline the experience, but in the end, the soothing charms of Animal Crossing keep me coming back to True North and this series that has mastered the tasteful art of relaxation in video games. And according to all my friends and the sales figures around the world, it seems that art is something we all need right now. Thank you for watching my EZ64 review of Animal Crossing New Horizons. This was probably my most anticipated title for 2020. There are other games that have vied for my attention, but truly there's no other game this year that I have put 200 hours into, and that time is still growing with this game. And it's, like I said, I'm really excited about what else they could add to it. And I hope you guys are too. Let me know in the comments how you've been experiencing New Horizons in the past few months. And if you like EZ64 reviews, stick around. I have one more coming tomorrow about the Bayonetta games. So I'll see you then. Thanks for watching.